Hey y'all, welcome back to Twin Oaks Family Farm in Southeast Ohio, USA. This is chow time in the meat bird barn. You can see that we have more or less all of the little birds in this flock at their feeders. And there are actually a couple feeders on over, but they're concentrating around this main row of feeders. So these birds are 2 weeks old. They are being raised for poultry production. They're Cornish rock cross meat chickens. Cornish rock cross meat chickens are excellent at rapid growth, efficient feed to meat conversion, and distribution of the meat into the chicken breasts, the drumsticks, and the thighs. And that distribution of meat happens really in about the last 2 weeks of production. Okay, so I want to show you a little peek at a comparison that you don't frequently get, and we don't really have them side by side, but I think you'll get a good idea of a comparison here if I can get the camera to a little different position. So these are Cornish rock cross meat chickens right at 2 weeks old, okay, 14 days old. And over here on the other side of this short wall, we have, here's a good example one, Rhode Island Reds that are exactly the same age. So you can kind of get a sense, same size feeder, we just don't have the lids on that feeder, but you can get a sense of the size of that bird. Okay, so that's a Rhode Island Red, she went on over, that is the same age as these Cornish rock cross. Okay, so the Rhode Island Red that you saw, the smaller chick, same age as these, but that smaller chick, so let's see if we can get, so there. So they're gonna go into egg production. They'll start laying eggs at about 5 months old. These birds will actually go to be butchered at 6 weeks old. So they'll be ready for poultry production at just 6 weeks of age, at 42 days. But we filled feeders, and they had emptied the feeders prior to having them filled just now. So they were ready to eat. So, you know, we see a strong reaction in general in meat birds to feed. Sometimes we see a strong reaction in our egg production older hens when we put feed in, because they're, you know, they're on a feed ration or a feed schedule. So even with our, like our mature egg production hens, they're happy when we bring feed in and they'll go right to feed and eat. But meat chickens are even more excited about chow time. So generally, you know, we let them eat the feeders empty in their pen, and then we get them filled quickly after the birds have emptied them. And a lot of times when you do fill the feeders and have them all filled, that does trigger the birds to want to go to eat. So Cornish rock cross meat chickens in general do have a strong reaction to going to eat. They like to eat. They have a heavy appetite, and they're supposed to have a heavy appetite. If you're raising Cornish rock cross meat chickens and they don't have a heavy appetite, that's actually more concerning than if they do. So, but it's always kind of neat when they do all more or less feed at once. It's really kind of neat to see them all lined up, but it really emphasizes something that's very important in managing Cornish rock cross meat chickens. When you are raising a flock, you need to take into consideration the number of birds that you have in your flock and the amount of supplies that you have and the amount of space that those supplies give the flock for access to food and water. And this is a wonderful illustration where it really emphasizes that it's very important to have enough space at the feeders for all of the birds to eat at the same time if they want to. Because if you could imagine, as it is, you know, we see some birds have already eaten, have got their fill, they're relaxing there under a heat lamp. But as it is, if you could imagine if they only had half the feeders and only had half the feeder space, they would just be climbing all over each other. It would be a frenzy, okay? So it is important. That's a very important consideration when you're going to raise meat birds, especially that you have enough feeder space basically for all the birds to eat at once if they would choose to. And you can see we actually have some additional space back there at feeders. It's not being utilized. And they'll still, just like that one, you know, climbed right over top of other ones. So that is something to be mindful of. With water, you also want to have lots of room for many birds to access water at the same time. And so at 2 weeks old, this is the juncture we're at with these birds. You can see the waters look huge. Those will hold 5 or 6 gallons of water at a time. We've been using, so we've pulled these out. They're ready to actually clean and sanitize and put away, because we're done with those for 2024. Those hold a gallon. That's what had previously been in here, and they were drinking through them so fast that even with having like 10 of them in here, we were filling them, you know, about 3 times a day. So we went ahead and put 4 of the large capacity waters in, and we let them, you know, drink those down, and then we're able to clean the trays out and keep them maintained for the birds and keep plenty of water in there. But they've, with 4 of those big waters, they've got lots of room to get around the water. So we're getting the same thing with feeders. We've got large feeders. So I think I can turn around here and show you. So we've got these large feeders. We are ready. The birds are eating at capacity where we're ready to be done with these baby feeder trays and get the big feeders in there. But you can also see between the birds and the supplies, it's a balancing act to work with the amount of space that we have, okay? Now, we have a lot of space to expand, so actually that's the point we're at, and we'll probably just have to wait to the weekend at this point because of just time constraints. The birds have plenty of room in here, but with putting in the bigger waters and wanting to put in the bigger feeders, and them growing, we basically just need to expand the footprint, expand the space, okay? But the other consideration that has to be weighed in there is the ambient conditions, and we're trying to hit, you know, a target temperature zone that's comfortable for our chicks, for our birds, so that that supports their ability to grow and thrive and be successful meat birds. And that's why we have these heat lamps suspended. So where they're at, they have 6. So, you know, something we have to consider is if we give them more room in a direction where we can't also give them more warmth, it's not really going to end up helping them or us. Because if we have like a nighttime temperature of like 30 degrees and they all want to be under heat lamps, we're back to that same balancing act with access and with space. So we need to expand that direction into that pen where the Rhode Island Reds are. So that's going to actually work out okay, but you know, we need a little bit of time to be in here and do that and do it calmly and make it a process that does not stress birds out. So so we'll have some time here in a couple days to do that. So that's what we'll do basically. I think what we're going to do at this point, the short wall that you're looking at right there in the camera, we're just going to unfasten it and move it down probably to about here. Okay, and that's okay because then that'll still leave all that space right there for those Rhode Island Reds, but that'll expand their space, you know, out that much more. Plus, it won't allow us to use that set of heat lamps right there that's low, but we've got a set of heat lamps here that will be suspended. So that'll add 2 heat lamps to what these birds have. It'll just give us more room. So that's going to be a good expansion for them. So basically, we're kind of at a turning point where we would have considered the last 2 weeks the starting phase for these chicks when we were brooding them. And now we're moving into a 2-week phase that we'll consider the growing phase. And then after that will be the final 2 weeks that we consider the finish stage. And different milestones are happening in all of those stages. So kind of, you know, short story, in the first couple weeks, you know, they're getting their immune system working, getting the organs working, getting thermoregulation happening where they can kind of adjust their own body temperature, you know, to be comfortable. Second stage, they're putting on feathers, they're growing their skeletal structure. And third stage, they're converting feed to meat. Where in the earlier stages, their feed is going into energy for those other tasks. So they're really doing good, but we will want to be expanding room, getting them into the big feeders. It's we're ready to put fresh bedding down, but this flock is doing great. Thanks for joining us, y'all. Check back in, please.